Give me a break, Kyrie.
Sorry, you lazy bum. I knew that I'd find you snoozing down here.
No, this huge black thing swallowed me up. I couldn't breathe, I couldn't... Ow!
Are you still dreaming?
It wasn't a dream. Or was it? I don't know. What was that place? So bizarre.
Yes, sure.
Say, Kyrie, what was your hometown like? You know, where you grew up?
I've told you before. I don't remember.
Nothing at all?
Nothing.
You ever want to go back?
Well, I'm happy here.
Really?
But you know, I wouldn't mind going to see it.
I'd like to see it too. Along with any other worlds out there. I want to see them all.
So what are we waiting for?
Hey! Aren't you guys forgetting about me? So, I guess I'm the only one working on the raft. And you're just as lazy as he is.
So you noticed. Okay, we'll finish it together. I'll race you.
Huh?
What? Are you kidding?
Ready? Go!
Hello everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. So as you can see, we're on a deserted little island here named Destiny Island. Or as I like to call it, Cocomo. That's right. It's the place where I want to go. So today, we're going to be collecting the items that you need to complete the raft on the first day.
Hey, what's happening, man?
And we're going to be talking to the three recipients of the island that are not the main characters, Waka, Tidus, and Selphie. Yes, I'll be showing you how to beat them. There's varying ways to beat them. Now, the first thing about Waka is he lobs blitzballs at you. When he does this, you can reflect them. I'm kind of rusty at this point, especially against fighting against Waka, so I used to know how to do it in the air. I think I'll demonstrate it right about here. Yeah, there you go. Just jump up and hit it at the right time, and you can just lob it back at him, and it'll daze him for a little bit longer. I believe just about one more throw's worth. So this is the easiest way to beat Waka, not to get hit by the blitzball, no, but is to hit the blitzballs back at him, and then when he's dazed, you can go up and hit him. Excuse me, if you want to beat him quickly. Now, he has a super blitz ball, as you just saw, which comes fast, and it hits pretty hard, actually. So, my suggestion is, don't waste your time on training with Waka, as he is the worst of the three beginning challenges to actually train with, because he just isn't that great.
The breeze feels great.
No, I just said it wasn't that great. Anyway, so this is Selphie from Final Fantasy VIII, as I mentioned before. Now, there's a little something about Selphie that I am going to show after I beat her in a duel.
Hey, don't hold back.
Don't think poorly of me for it. But anyway,
yeah.
For Selphie, she's got two attacks. One where she does a leaping she's got three. She's got one where she leaps at you and throws a... it's a jump rope. She throws her jump rope at you, and she's got one where she comes at you with kind of like a twirl, as you saw, and then she's got that one where she just runs up to you and just tries to hit you. You can reflect every single attack back at her except for the twirl one where she just kind of stops for a moment. Selphie is the easiest of the characters to fight against, and she also provides the second best amount of experience. The only trouble with training against Selphie is that... as you do get 2 experience for reflecting her attack here, see, I've got her in a pattern, you can just keep doing this, getting experience, She is doing damage to herself, so eventually the fight will end from her own stupidity. Sadly. So, I'm not gonna waste any more time, and I'm going to move on to Titus, who is, without a doubt, the best character to train on while you're on Destiny Island. But first, I said I would show you something about Selphie, and that is the fact that, yes, if you go down here, and you go into a first-person view, here, I'll show you. Go to a first-person view, and you look, yes, you can see her panties. There's a barrel on this part of the island, somewhere near the waterfall. If you're, for whatever reason, a pervert, I guess you can look at it if you want. I'm not going to, more than what I already showed you, but just a little fun fact for you nasty, nasty pedophiles out there, I guess. So, anyway, you need to climb up here and get this to get the cloth, which is the sail for the raft. So, yes, fun times. Now we just jump back down, climb here, and follow this little snake way, whatever you want to call it, this little way right here, and we reach Cetus. But we want to pick this up first, which is the rope. Now there's only one item left that we need for the raft.
Hey, Sora, you feel lucky today?
But first, we're going to fight Cetus. Now, I'm just showing you, every time I refuse them for the first time, I'm showing you what they say after. It's not a big deal, but now, the reason Cetus is the best to train against is because he offers 2 experience when you clash your sword with him, and you want to just kind of do it how I'm doing it here. You hit, or you do the repulse, and then you back away, then you go again. And if he follows you like this, just turn around almost immediately after a few steps, and you know, just clash swords. And like I said, he provides 2 experience every single time. It's very quick, and the best part is you can keep doing this because he doesn't hurt himself. The only time he hurts himself is when he, he never hurts himself. It's the only time he hurts him, the only time he gets hurt is when you hit him. But anyway, he has 3 types of attacks. One of them is a follow-up attack to the initial attack that we keep blocking. It's basically he does a normal slash, and then he does another one that you can't repel. Well, you can repel it and not take damage, but you won't get experience for. The third type of attack is the one that you saw earlier, which is the backflip. So, I mean, I guess really he only has 2, but the first one has a follow-up, so I usually count it up as a different attack because it's a different motion. So, but that's just me. So anyway, as you can see here, he gets quite a bit of experience. Now, the one thing with Titus is that he will stop to rest because he gets tired. So, if this happens, you can either wait, or because I get impatient sometimes, I hit him because I'm like, come on, Titus, no time to rest now. The thing about Titus is that he is the best character to train on the island, regardless of what anyone says. This will always be true, you know, just him versus you. Now, there's one more thing I wanted to say about Titus. I think it was kind of strange that they gave him a red stick. I think they should have given him a blue one, because I think that would have followed his character more, considering he uses an aqua sword. I know he uses a red sword at the beginning of the game, but to me that's not that big a deal. So anyway, yes, after defeating all 3 of them, you now have the option to face against all 3 of them at the same time. I don't think I'm going to be showing that just yet, or I might, I'm not sure. No. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to actually go and face Riku now. Yes, you can fight Riku, but you can only fight Riku on the first day. Also, we need to pick up something else at Riku's Island here. I call it Riku's Island because, you know, this is where you find him at the beginning of the game. Anyway, on Riku's Island here, you find the last item that you need for the first day, which is the second log. So after this, you can go back to Kairi, and you can end the first day. But I'm going to face Riku at level 5. I don't have any skills or abilities yet, just some basic stat gains. I'm going to show you how difficult this can be. I'll be honest with you, I lose here. And in the next episode, I have a save file where I beat him the first time. I'm going to be using that save file because I am OCD and I do not like losing against Riku. So, this is quite difficult. What I did right there was very dangerous. You could have fallen off right there. So yeah, but I should probably go over the fight with Riku. Riku has a variety of different attacks. He's got the whirl or vortex attack, as you see there. He's got two regular type swings. The first one there, you can block. The second one, as you see, you cannot block. And he can also block himself. Now, every time he does block, if you hit him three times, he will always repel with an attack that you can block for experience. Now, there's times where Riku gets pushed over, as you can see. When he does this, he does kind of like a horse kick, as I like to call it. Because it's kind of like a horse, I don't know. But he does kind of like a kick, which is very strong. My suggestion, move out of the way of it. It does a good percent of damage, at least 15% of your health worth of damage. As you can see, I just keep getting hit by it, which is going to be the reason I fail, especially that hit right there. He got lucky with that. I didn't see it coming. And he takes me out here. So yeah, like I said, I lose. But it's not that big a deal. And then at the beginning of the next episode, I will go to this fight again. And I will have a win. And you will like it. You will like it, Riku. I will kick your ass. Anyway, okay. So yeah, that'll be it for this episode. Now, what I want to do is I want to go train with Titus until Sora is level 12. For a very important reason, which I will show you next time on Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. Have a good day.